For our next hot copy, newly appointed COMELEC Commissioner Ernesto Maceda Jr. has been requested by COMELEC Chair George Garcia to lead the poll body's task force against vote buying. He will also be part of the Committee on Election Reforms. Now, here to tell us more about it and his plans as commissioner, we have Ernesto Maceda Jr. Good morning to you, Commissioner.
Good morning, Karen. Good morning to all your loyal viewers, both here in the Philippines and abroad. TFC, napakalakas lalo na sa North America.
All right. Well, maraming salamat. Thank you for being on the show. Congratulations to you. So you have a term that's still 2029, am I correct? And professionally, of course, you're a known constitutionalist. You taught election law, administrative law in several universities. Prior to your appointment, you were at the Ateneo Law School. But now you are being assigned to something very specific in the COMELEC, which is the task force on vote buying. I want to ask you first, were you surprised with your appointment?
Well, as I was telling the other interviewers, Karen, I offered my services. No, mm-hmm. It's an honor and a privilege for anybody to take part in nation building. And it was to the constitutional commissions that I specifically asked to be considered, given that, as you said, I've been teaching this subject for 30 years over. Mm-mm. So it was not a surprise, but I am grateful for this opportunity.
Okay. And what would you be focusing on? I mean, vote buying is such a, it's almost so vague today because there's so many ways to do it. What would you do?
Well, precisely, that's one of the reasons why it's like a cycle. It keeps repeating every electoral season. The usual context when you hear about vote buying is, you'll find out that there is a crowd somewhere. There's a payout you hear. Mm-hmm. And if let's say if the COMELEC had the manpower, which it does not, mm-hmm. then it would be able to check out all these reports in the 81 provinces, or 82 already, or 83, 150, almost 1,500 municipalities, almost 42,000 barangays. But we do have the power to deputize the police force and other enforcement arms of the government. But nonetheless, once you arrive at the spot, if that's where you tend to ambush the activity, mm-hmm. what you see is a payout. And the normal explanation there is, well, I'm paying my watchers, you know. Mm-hmm. And or if you do chance upon people with the envelope and money in hand, The provision on vote buying is a provision that criminalizes the offering of money or something of value in exchange for a vote or the promise not to vote. So the prosecution becomes a problem as well. So the task force actually was created not upon my assumption, but it started around a month before this last election, and now after the election has been completed, we have revived the efforts. It started under Commissioner Ferolino. But it's a task force precisely because the commission realizes that, you know, it's not a standing committee, but the amount of reports or incidents of this happening has become too much to become inescapable. Among the right now, offhand, before I even meet with the task force members, I would think that on the table would be suggestions like, you know, if the usual context is payouts that you learn about, the explanation is we're just paying our watchers. In the automated overseas elections, there is a provision that if you have watchers, that they will all be registered. Mm-hmm. So that if you say that, for example, there are 100 watchers for your barangay or 100 precincts, then you register the watcher for each precinct. You cannot say that I have 100 precincts and then I have 500 watchers or 5 per precinct, unless mm-hmm. you register each one of them. Mm-hmm. So that would help, no? But otherwise, we're going to gather kakalap namin lahat ng mga provisions on this.
But the bigger challenge really is it's a question of relationships in the smaller LGUs. It's also a question of need for the voters. So, yan ang magandang tanong eh, kasi hindi naman lang, we've seen vote buying actually, the prices have, in the last election, you're hearing amounts of 10,000 per family, 20,000 per family. I mean, vote buying has been there since even during your father's time, frankly speaking, yes. Even before that. But then the amounts have gotten bigger and bigger through the years.
Mm-hmm. Well, whatever the amount, Karen, technically, magpakain ka lang sa kanto during an election. So a promise of value in exchange for a vote or not to vote, no? So this is a serious mission of the COMELEC, mm-hmm. and we're going to
but
listen
then,
to
do you believe, just, I don't mean to interrupt, that one of the issues really is the fact that you have not really, there's been no conviction of a high-profile politician, right? That's been talked about during elections, during the campaigns, as buying votes. Photos have spread over social media of yung pera hawak, binigay ng camp na ito. But really, there's no conviction on any politician that's won. That's really, you know, I mean, there's been proof that they've engaged in vote buying. Do you see this as the main weakness?
Well, one of the weaknesses, Karen, is that Section 266 of the Omnibus Election Code speaks of not allowing any arrests in connection with an election campaign for vote buying or other election offenses unless it is by virtue of a warrant.
No?
Unless you chance upon them in an in flagrante situation, kailangan sasampahan mo pa muna yan ng kaso sa...
Matagal!
Oo, tapos aabot pa sa korte. So that's one of the reasons. And then when the election is over, those who may have been ready to testify in the heat of the moment,
pagod na.
You know, everything on. And you know, pag nag-cool down na ho yung mga passions and emotions, parang okay, let's just get along, no? So these are the matters which we are going to have to take up in our task force so that, mm-mm. as you said, you know, the impression that nothing ever happens, nobody ever gets caught. You know, this impacts on our image or credibility.
Yeah.
Not just the commission, but all the COMELEC from the top to the bottom.
Uh-oh. Is it possible to actually amend or reverse, take out that certain provision in 2666 of the Omnibus Election Code?
Yeah, I wasn't part of the commission yet, but I watched as Chairman George and Commissioner Bulay, who is a city prosecutor, faced the Commission on Electoral Suffrage of Senator Marcos, and they were discussing this precisely. So there's a good partnership now with both committees of both the House and the Senate, and that brings us also to the other duty that I think the chairman was speaking out loud first. Mm-hmm. No, but we have an en banc meeting later, and maybe we will formalize it. The election reform, no? Mm-hmm. Revision of election laws. Senator Marcos was saying that, and I know, that the Batas Pambansa 881 is a circa 1985 election code.
Yeah.
It was at the time na wala pang modernization, all of these other challenges were not, you know, in the environment. So that's also part of what the chair has asked me to look into.
Actually, by this time, I was thinking, since how would you describe the NBank in terms of the age range? I mean, it seems that the fact that the COMELEC chairman is also younger, I would say, and mm-hmm. you and then other appointees, would there be, I would assume at this point, it's 2022, there should already be a list of what needs to be amended or revised to actually modernize some of our election laws.
Yes, and for that, Karen, well, first, thank you for including me in the Team Bunso with Chairman George. George, actually...
Because it should be also, the COMELEC should now be more innovative, more aggressive, right? For, you know, and more creative for change, because in a way, you're all coming into this much younger than, let's say, former COMELEC commissioners, with all due respect. to their expertise as well.
And I'm only beginning to discover, because I'm in the middle of briefing. In fact, some of the briefing departments are just outside the door. There are efforts being undertaken by the men and women on the ground. The chair and the commissions, they may rotate, they may come in and serve their 7 years. But the rest of the commission are here until they retire. No? And one of the reasons why you think, or there is an impression that, you know, there should be more innovation, we're really so... kulang kami sa tao karan eh.
Okay.
So what happens is if you are focused on one particular responsibility of the COMELEC, when something else comes in, you have to drop this first, no? So I think it's a function. It's a function of staffing and budget. But if we had dedicated personnel for each and every one of these, the responsibility of the COMELEC is really so vast, no? So ideally, if we're able to do that, then it's fine. But I may discover that they are already doing these very things that you're talking about. Then we will supply the initiative for as long as our energy level is here at the beginning. And so we hope to sustain it until the end of our term.
All right.
Then contribute.
Okay, my last question. What mark would you want to leave? It's very difficult to be a namesake of a very famous father. One would say, what mark would you want to leave? Clearly, you didn't run for public office at any point, have you, in the past?
I was,
counselor.
Part of the council in 1988.
Yeah,
but I gave up. I gave up and entered the public academe. What mark do I want to leave? Well, in this position, I want to be able to serve and to carry out my functions as independently as I can. Being a part of the academe, my role, if I were to ignite a fire, then I would welcome that opportunity to criticize constructively, to comment fairly, to question intelligently, and to challenge the status quo, so that we do not always just rest on our laurels. You know, mahirap maging kampante. We should prepare. Even if the last national and local elections were very successful, were highly successful, we should prepare for the next great accomplishment.
Okay. All right. And I do hope to have you back on the show, because we can talk next time about more specifics. We can talk about, frankly speaking, also the BSK elections, the next national elections, whether we'll get new machines, et cetera, and where the COMELEC is headed and how it's preparing. So thank you so much, Commissioner, for joining me today.
Thank you very much, Karen. Thank you also for mentioning my father. He also held you in very high regard.
Thank you. Commissioner Maseda, thank you for joining, and good luck to you, sir.